So being able to come here and be able to compete was already a big thing for me. And making the finals, it's also a big thing for me. And now I have to think that I have this opportunity to put all the bad energy and just go for it for the biggest jump as possible.
And of course, you're coming off of 2021 was a huge year for you, where you, of course, got silver and then you jumped 15 meters. How do you use that momentum coming into this World Championships?
I usually tend to not to think too much about it because it's something that is in the past, unless it's something that some feelings, some emotions, some learnings, technical learnings that I've could have performed in Tokyo, and I have to bring it now. But I am very aware that this is a new opportunity, this is a new time, and then just because I got silver doesn't mean that the next competition is going to be just the same. I still have to work hard, I still have to show to myself that I'm capable of jumping far. And I'm just thinking actually ahead and trying to take the positives from the competition and then just putting on today's competition, today's feelings, today's emotions, today's mindset, so I can even push harder to jump even further.
And just curious, how do you remain so consistent after so many years? You've been jumping for such a long time at such a high level. How do you, you know, maintain that longevity?
I think recovery. I pay a lot of attention of recovery. I've been struggling a lot with a lot of problems since ever, because triple jump is very tough on the body. But I also learned a lot how to be kind with my body, and then understanding when I'm pushing too hard and maybe I need to slow it down. Trying to prevent a lot, doing a lot of physio, a lot of prevention, a lot of core work. And I think it's been working for me. I'm still here. I don't even remember when I started triple jumping, but in high level, I'm pretty sure I started like more than 10 years ago. So as long as my body has the energy and the capacity to jump, I'll just keep going.
Just through the questions, you're of course you compete for Portugal, but you also have roots in Angola, right? Can you talk to me about that?
But both my parents, they were born in Angola. Even though my dad has, I think, Congolese background, because he lived very north of Angola in Ouij. And I think the genetics is also helps a lot, even though I was born and raised in Portugal, and I wear everything that I learned, all the technical aspects, all the technology I learned in Portugal, I still have this very big attachment, blood that is Angola, pretty much is that I have, and the culture also, because I grew up listening and feeling both cultures. And I think I just have the best of the two worlds, and then just combining it, and yeah, this is me.
Have you gotten the chance to go and visit Angola, where your parents are from?
No, and I'm feeling really bad about it, because my dad just went last month. After 35 years, he went back to Angola, and he was just showing me, and then he was just actually doing life with people in Angola, and most of the people know me. I was like, this is so crazy. Imagine when I go there, it's going to be amazing. And because I need to know like where my roots are, and I think it's very important. But also track is very hard, at least for me. I practice all year. Sometimes I have 2 weeks off, and then trying to do all media stuff. So I really have to, in the next Olympic cycle, have to go to Angola and to feel where all my roots came from.
And last question, you are like really active on social media, and you put out some like, you know, super engaging posts, whether it's like promoting something or even just promoting yourself. Talk to me about your activity on social media.
Actually, lately it's been a little bit low because I've been struggling a lot, but I use social media in a way to connect to people and also to show like a little bit of the life of athlete, which is not quite easy, because even though sometimes I show like the best part, but when I have opportunity, I also show something about how it is to be athlete, because people have to be more, they have to understand how is living. Or how is to be an athlete 24 hours a day, which is not easy, because sometimes we go to competition and everybody expects us to excel, and they don't know the background, they don't know the sacrifice you have to make, they don't know how happy I am when I see my family, when basically in all year I just see them like for a couple of days. So I try to also, it's like nowadays way of communication, and then if I want to know like how my friends and how some of my competitors are doing. So I also use social media to obtain that. But it's very important also for our image, because nowadays image is also very, very important to push yourself out there. So I just try to take social media in a positive way.
Patricia Mamona, going to the finals, looking forward to it.
Thank you so much.